Can people hear me? Yes, okay. What we're going to do is make demand. We're making demand for no eviction whatsoever. We're making demand that the city give money that they have to the people,
oh, you are? Okay.
To the community, to be able to buy what?
Apartment.
Supervisor David Campos. He's so sorry he's not here himself. He's in committee at City Hall, but he is with us in spirit. We are working with the community on a variety of legislative changes and different laws to protect tenants in the city and to protect the limited rent and price-controlled housing that we have left. However, and in addition, to build more new affordable housing, because that's what we truly need. We don't need more housing generally in the city. What we need is more affordable housing. The majority of us do not afford $1 million one-bedroom apartment or condo. We need houses, family housing, houses for seniors that people, everyday San Franciscans can afford, and we are fighting for that. But we also want to say that we are, and Supervisor Campos is 100% behind the eviction-free San Francisco organizing model, because it's not just about changing laws. In order to protect one another, we have to all engage, and we have to all work together, and we have to organize. So thank you so much to Abe, thank you so much to Meta, thank you so much to Papahuska, thank you so much to the House of Rights Committee, thank you so much to Arlington Eviction, thank you so much to JobCan, thank you so much to all of the organizations that are here and that are fighting every day, and for each and every one of you that are joining into this movement that is growing. We are not going to lose our city. It's our city.
Buenas tardes a todos. Estamos acá para hacerle que caer en cuenta la gente que los que llevamos mucho tiempo viviendo acá merecemos vivir en esta ciudad y merecemos vivir en este vecindario, porque de lo contrario va a perder todo el sabor y el color latino que tiene la misión. Trabajo para Meda y ahorita en este momento estamos tratando de comprar propiedades que están en el mercado donde sabemos que hay inquilinos que llevan mucho tiempo. Pero estamos compitiendo contra inversionistas que quieren hacer dinero muy rápido y que básicamente la forma de hacerlo es desplazando a las personas que viven ahí. Queremos pedirle a la ciudad que incremente los fondos. Es un fondo apenas de 3 millones de dólares, que con eso no compramos ni un edificio y necesitamos más dinero, porque ya hemos visitado alrededor de la misión unas 15 propiedades donde hay más o menos unas 40 unidades donde viven muchas familias, que si no hacemos algo van a desplazar a esas familias. Entonces es importante que asistan, es importante que los latinos salgamos. Casi siempre hay muchos activistas que están apoyando, pero necesitamos que las familias latinas con niños vengan a las reuniones y expresen por qué es importante para ellos vivir en este vecindario. Toda su vida la han hecho acá. Esta es un barrio de inmigrantes, de clase trabajadora, y no hacemos nada. Para el 2020 no va a haber sino una tercera parte de latinos y una tercera parte de personas ganando menos de 50 mil dólares al año. Este va a ser uno de los barrios exclusivos de San Francisco y no lo podemos permitir. El próximo miércoles en la Escuela César Chávez vamos a tener una reunión donde va a venir en la oficina de vivienda del alcalde y la oficina de planificación, el supervisor Campos y todos los grupos comunitarios que quieren buscar soluciones para el problema de vivienda. Necesitamos que los latinos participen en la reunión. Gracias.
She faced eviction through the fact that she's going to sing now.
Hi, my name is Marty Susanis, and I've lived here over 50 years in all of San Francisco. The Mission, the Sunset, Noe Valley, and now I'm way out by the ocean. And I was Ellis Act evicted 8 years ago. I was with the first wave, which was about 80% of us were seniors. And I'm 72 years old, and now I found a place after I was evicted, but I had to pay over $1,000 more, which has been a terrible struggle for me to do it. And now my landlord keeps raising the rent so that he can keep up with the market rate. That's his excuse. I'm an excellent tenant. We have a good relationship. I told him that I live on a social security income of $618. I have to keep working until I literally just fall down. But if I have to fall down, I want to do it fighting this issue, because I've had enough. And let me tell you something about which comes back to mind. A few years ago, when I was Ellis Act evicted, I don't know if I mentioned that I got breast cancer in the middle of this. I can't remember. I've talked so many times. I did. I got breast cancer from the stress, and I actually really wanted to die at that point, because my home is not just my home. It's where I work. I work out of my home. And I have my own business, and I write, and I have a small office. And if I lose my home, I lose my business, I lose my income. And who can live on $618 a month anywhere, not even in Vallejo? Now, there's one last thing that I just want to say that really was very poignant for me when I was in this process. I remember walking through or driving through the Mission south of Market, where a lot of the homeless struggle to survive on Mission near 6th and 7th. Back then it was mostly all homeless living there. And I remember driving by a construction site with someone who had spray painted a graffiti on that construction site, and my heart just stopped when I saw this. Four words, four simple, humble, and poignant words. about that graffiti. And I have good days and I have bad days. And on the really bad days, in the middle of the night when the kids lay awake, that's like, that's when I feel like I'm just waiting to die too. Now we're going to march to 22nd and Salvanet to Carlos Gutierrez Court. The speaker we had has been evicted. So please follow us. Thank you. Yes, please let the banner go first and we go behind the banner.
I'm is that? We got a big, big back. The green is that? We got a big back. The green is that? We got a big, big back. The green is that? Back. Green is that?
Coming out. you're being